Hello there, my beautiful Aries friends. How are you? Welcome back to Sacred Knowledge Tarot. I am so happy and thankful to each and every one of you for being here with me today. So thank you, everyone. And those of you that are brand new to my channel, hello and welcome. My name is Rhea and I do these readings every week. Now, Aries, I'm going to start your reading off with a passage from this beautiful book called The Luminous, Humanness. It's written by Kelly Sullivan Walden. After I read you this passage, I'm going to go ahead and pull three cards out of my tarot deck to see what message spirit has for you. After that, I'm going to pull a bonus card from the Earth, Moon, and Shadow Oracle. And then I'm going to pull an angel number for you as well. So those of you that have been seeing angel numbers anywhere in your life right now, this is going to give you your confirmation and guidance. So stay tuned for all of this, my beautiful friends. Now, Aries, your passage today is called You're Rocking It. You're doing great, Aries. You might not realize it, but it's important for you to know it now. The strides you've made and the breakthroughs you've created, not to mention the risks you've bravely taken, have been exceptional and have led you here. This precise moment in your life, even if it doesn't seem like it to your ordinary perception, is a mountaintop experience. How powerful is that? I love this passage. Now, this also comes with an affirmation. I'm going to read that to you as well. I take in the view, letting it energize me while I prepare to summit the next peak. So you can use that affirmation for yourself if you like today. Thank you so much, Aries, for allowing me to share that passage with you today. Now, I'm going to shuffle these cards, and as I'm doing this, I wanted to announce that I am reopening my personal readings October the 15th. So any of you that are interested in booking a personal reading with me, my information is in the description box below. All right, everyone, let's pull some cards and see what spirit would like you to know today. All right, so we're going to start here with the Queen of Wands. This is such a beautiful card, a beautiful energy here. And what spirit guides are asking is that you ground your energy. I feel there's a lot of energy within you right now, and there's a lot that you want to do. I do feel that a lot of you are wanting to grow and expand in your life. This is all going to happen for you. And it's all about preserving your energy as well. So we're going to take a look at this card a little bit more in detail. But what I want you to do here, Aries, is to use your own intuition with my reading. So whenever you see my cards popping up, I want you to try and interpret them using your intuition. Not only will it strengthen your intuition, but you will also receive your own messages. All right, so we're starting here with the Queen of Wands. Ten of Wands. Look at all of that energy. And I feel for some of you, with the Ten of Wands being present in your spread, there's a lot of energy being put towards things that don't require your energy, Aries. And I do feel that because of this, you're feeling overwhelmed, overburdened. There's a lot of responsibilities, day-to-day tasks that you are kind of working towards. But I feel there's this unnecessary energy being kind of divvied up through different things in your life. So this is where spirit guides are asking a lot of you to take a look at some of the things that you're doing in your day-to-day life and release yourself from some of the things that don't serve your higher purpose here, okay? So we'll take a look at this as well. And remember, everyone, we all live a different life experience. So these cards are going to present themselves differently in each of our lives. We are getting the Queen of Pentacles. So again, that grounding is going to be very important. You have two Queen cards here, Aries. So spirit guides are asking a lot of you to be open and receptive. There's a lot that is coming in, and this is confirming that you're going to experience that growth. You are going to experience that abundance. There is an opportunity coming towards you if it already hasn't. Okay, so I'm going to take a look at these cards and see what my intuition is drawing in. Now, I don't know if any of you are seeing number one or number two anywhere in your life. These could be angel numbers, 111, 222. If you are, spirit guides are wanting you to, they're actually calling you to embody the life path one and the life path two. You might already be a life path one or two. And if you're not, spirit guides are wanting you to look those numbers up to see what it is that you're meant to embody, right? That energy of those life paths, because there is guidance coming through those. And I feel somewhere in your life, if you're able to embody those energies, you're going to be able to work through some of the things that you are facing right now. So the Queen's energy, the Queen of Wands, really putting your energy towards the things that you want to see growth in all the areas of your life that you want to see growth in. And sometimes what happens here is because we have the Ten of Wands energy, we have a lot of things that are going on. And I feel for some of you, with the Ten of Wands energy, there's a path here. It's very clear, but there's almost like a blockage, and you're so close here, Aries. You're so close of finding it, but there needs to be some sort of lifting of this heavy weight, okay? And this is where spirit guides want you to really look at kind of everything that you're putting your energy towards. This could be with people. This could be in your work. This could be, you know, mundane tasks. This could be your thoughts, right? Wherever your energy is going, that is where, you know, wherever you're focusing your energy, that is kind of what is growing in your life. So I want you to think about the things that you're thinking about here, Aries. I want you to write down your thoughts and, you know, documenting your thoughts. And analyzing them is going to really help you in a big way, because this is going to help you kind of figure out where you're putting a lot of your energy, especially your thought energy, okay? And I do feel a lot of you have a lot of energy to give out. Like, you really want to see things happening in your life. You're very bubbly, you're very energetic, and that energy that some of you have sometimes can, and this is not going to resonate for everyone, right? But when we have a lot of energy and that energy is like pent up, it can come out in different ways, like anger, frustration, irritation, right? All these different ways. So this is where spirit guides want you to start releasing some of those energies where they might feel like blockages, in order to open that path, because you're going to be able to walk straight through onto that path by releasing some of these wands that are in your way. Okay, this is kind of what is happening here. And by being compassionate toward yourself, by being loving toward yourself, by nurturing your mind and your thoughts with positive affirmations and positive thinking, you're going to be able to release some of those energies. And what I'm seeing in my mind right now, I don't know why this is coming up, but it's a Five of Cups. And they're really showing me the three cups that are kind of turned over and spilt over. And any of you out there that are kind of focusing your attention and energy on the cups that have spilled over, they want you to know there are two other cups there, okay? So there's a lot of positivity in our lives, and sometimes we forget to look at the good things in our lives because we're so focused on the negative things that are happening. So this is all about reshifting your focus and your energy towards all the things that are good happening in your lives. Remember, you have come a long way here, Aries. Okay, you are in this place right now because of all the accomplishments that you have had in your life, right? All of the obstacles that you have overcome over the course of your life, and you have gained a superpower. So you have to take a look at your tool belt that has all of these superpowers that you've already acquired over the course of your life, and you need to tap into those in order to move forward and kind of break down some of these barriers. These could be limitations and restrictions, and sometimes what we do is we put these on ourselves, whether we know this or not, right? And these could be thought. I feel a lot of the time these are thoughts that we think. If we can become free thinkers and think for ourselves and not allow outside forces to control us, like influences that are outside of us, right? We're going to be able to live a much happier and better life. So this is where spirit guides want you to take control of that energy. Really analyze where it is that you're putting your focus and attention here, Aries, and nurture the areas of your life that you want to see growth in. Because when you start to nurture those areas, once you start to water those plants that you want to see growth in, you're going to see them grow. Okay, and it's funny how plants know that if there's light, it nourishes them, they're able to grow. But if there is no light, it's darkness, then they start to wilt. This is the energy that I'm seeing here. So maybe there's no light on you right now, or perhaps there is some light on you, but you need to add more of that light that helps you grow. And only you know what this is, Aries. Remember, we are all different human beings, and that light is going to be different for each and every one of us. So that light for you, Aries, is light that makes your heart sing. So you need to do more of what makes your heart sing. Put your energy and attention to all the things that actually make your heart sing. Okay, and put care, put your attention, put your loving energy, nurture those parts of your life. This is what spirit guides are asking you. And being open and receptive to all the energies that are coming towards you as well. And these blockages, these feel like blockages. They're actually not blockages. These are, it's almost like we create these barriers, sometimes unwillingly. And these could be fears. These could be even obligations. These could be your habits. These could be patterns. So recognizing them and dealing with them, learning how to manage them. I feel that our brain is a very powerful force, that whatever we think, whatever we focus our attention on is what happens. We give life to it through our thoughts, right? So perhaps some of you are putting too much attention to thoughts that might not be helping you grow, right? Focusing too much on the things that aren't working in your life. You want to focus on the opposite of that. Okay, this is kind of what spirit guides are wanting you to understand here, Aries. And I feel for a lot of you, sometimes what happens is, because I'm getting a completion around this card, is you're completing something in your life. It's almost like you're tying up loose ends. I feel like the world card is coming in the back of my mind as well. There's just like this very, very busy energy. And I'm feeling exhausted here. So I feel some of you are feeling exhausted. I don't know if any of you have seen, I'm seeing a bunch of crows. So if you're experiencing a flock or a murder of crows somewhere in your life, if you've been seeing a crow following you around, or you're seeing, you know, a crow that has a certain behavior, it's so funny because they're showing me a crow kind of jumping around on the ground. So I don't know if it's like hopping around following you, or if you're seeing one near you somewhere that's kind of doing something funny. But there's a sign there for you, okay? So look up the crow meaning, the spiritual meaning for a crow. There is some transformation. There's some change coming into your life, okay? And I feel that sometimes when we see a crow in our life, it's letting us know that there are things in our lives that we're not seeing, that are kind of creating almost like this wall that is, you can't see the wall, but you're able to actually walk past it. And it's on a subconscious level. I hope I'm making sense here, because I'm going on a much more deeper area here. And what spirit guides want you to do here also, Aries, is listen to your intuition, listen to your gut instincts, okay? Because I feel that a lot of you are feeling those gut instincts, but you're kind of ignoring them. And, you know, surrender to your intuition here is what spirit guides are saying, and let go of the things that aren't benefiting you. Let go of some of these wands that you're carrying around, because these carry a lot of heavy weight. When you have a lot of heavy weight, and especially if you're running on empty, that's the other thing that they're showing me, is that some of you are running on empty, that you just don't have the energy. That's why I'm feeling that exhaustion energy. Like you're just exhausted, to some of you Aries out there. And I feel that you don't have time for you. I'm getting that as well. Like, I hear someone saying, I just don't have time for me. I just need some time for me. I just need time to do the things that I enjoy. So this is where you have to start to incorporate this for yourself, because you're going to experience a lot of growth and success. And you know what's going to end up happening here, Aries, is the minute you recognize all the things that are kind of holding you back, if they're holding you back, because I feel there's something that you're trying to break through to or break free from. So as soon as you do that, I'm seeing an opportunity coming in, an opportunity for your growth. This could be by you breaking free from whatever this is, releasing yourself. That is the opportunity for you to really grow. And you're going to see growth in your material world. So this could be growth at work, in a job. This could be growth in your finances. This could be growth with your relationships, right? Growth in many areas of your life here. And and I feel that some of you are going through some sort of a healing period here with the Ten of Wands energy as well, that some of you have been depleted of your energy because of all the obligations that have been on you for so long. So take all of these wands, these 10 wands, put them down, take a good look at them. Do they serve your higher purpose here, Aries? If they don't, we want to set them aside. Are you picking up responsibilities that aren't even yours? Are you picking up responsibilities that are someone else's, right? And you have to look at some of the relationships that you have in your life that are weighing down on you heavily or holding you back, right? You have to kind of look at those and have some open communication with partners, with family members, especially if you're feeling overwhelmed, and ask for support. And I know that asking for support can sometimes be very daunting. I used to do this in my own life where I thought it was a weakness to ask for support or ask for help. So I was the type of person that would be like, you know what, I'll just do it myself rather than relying on someone. And then, they're not meeting my expectations. I'd had many reasons why I wouldn't ask for help. And now that I've started asking for help, oh my gosh, Aries, I can't tell you how much better it is to receive help. And being open and communicating exactly what it is that you need, being clear about what it is that you need when you're asking for support, because sometimes people don't know how they can support you. Vice versa, if there's somebody in your life that is needing support, ask them how you can support them, right? So releasing yourself of responsibilities or obligations or any kind of limitations and restrictions that you feel are in your life here that might be just illusions, right? They might be just in your thoughts. Maybe it's something that you're assuming and it's not really true. So writing those thoughts down and giving yourself evidence of whether those are true or not, okay? And this growth, by doing all of this work for yourself, Aries, you're going to experience a lot of growth. I see that this is going to be an opportunity for you to really balance your life out a little bit. It's going to give you room to grow within yourself. I'm seeing a lot of self-development here as well. It's going to open some room up for you to do the things that you desire to do, things that are going to make your heart sing, right? So this is going to give you space and new energy for you to really explore not only yourself, but the things that you enjoy, bringing in a lot of happiness, bringing in things that are going to help you with that abundance and that growth, right? And I'm seeing that some of you are wanting to learn. You're wanting to read. You're wanting to pick up skill sets to enhance yourself, to add value to yourself. So I'm seeing a lot of that coming in as well. So setting aside time for yourself, you time, Aries, that you deserve here, my friends. So, and it's not selfish, because I'm getting this feeling of, I feel that it's selfish for me to want my own time because I have all of these responsibilities. I have all of these obligations. It's not selfish, Aries. So sometimes it's okay to be a little selfish, especially if you're feeling that you're depleted of energy, because you need to pull back and you need to fill your tank before you give your energy away. So sometimes the Ten of Wands, all it is let's go back, let's recharge, rejuvenate, and then get back to work, then start putting your energy outward, right? But if you're running on an empty tank, on empty energy here, it's just gonna it's not gonna do you any good here, my friends. So know that you're in a place that spirit guides are promising you and confirming with you, and they're saying yes. Some of you have been looking for an answer. Spirit guides are giving you the answer yes right now, okay? So yes to something that you're looking for an answer around or clarification on. They're letting you know this is your confirmation that you're going to experience a lot of growth in your material world. This could be a raise at work. This could be a new job that pays better. This could be a business that is going to grow and succeed. This is growth and success. This is abundance. This is financial freedom. This is independence for you. So I want you all to know that this is coming towards you. And it's you that's creating it by releasing things that no longer serve you and replacing with things that do. Okay, this could be anything. This could be skill sets. This could be just you spending more time learning about yourself, growing and expanding spiritually, even for some of you. Okay, so very powerful spread here for you today. I'm now going to pull a bonus card from the Earth, Moon, and Shadow Oracle. I'm going to read the interpretation from the guidebook for you. Okay, so let's see what spirit guides want you to know today, Aries. Oh my goodness, I really feel that some of you are going to move forward in your life by leaps and bounds. There's something that you're aiming for here, and spirit guides are letting you know that yes, Aries, you are going to reach that. It needs to be a little bit of change in habits as well, patterns that you have in your life, and you choosing to actually go for the goals, right? Rather than letting things distract you in your life right now. So the scavenger, desperation, scarcity, and waning is coming up. And there's that crow, my friends. So that crow is coming in. So again, what I'm getting here is this is tying in with the 10 of Wands energy. So let's pull the interpretation and read that to you right now. The scavenger. So the Buddha says there are three poisons that will rot the human soul: delusion, desire, and hatred. As humans, we live in a world where we are constantly bombarded by these poisons in the form of advertisements, social media, and television. We shave away at jobs we hate just to buy more stuff and things because of the fear of missing out. FOMO is what that's called, right? We are fed and consume all that we can possibly grasp with reckless abandon and pure gluttony, often at the expense of our planet, our health, and our sanity. When the scavenger is revealed in a reading, it is asking us to end the cycle of suffering. And this is what I feel this is, the cycle of suffering. It's a completion. So it needs to be, this cycle needs to be completed here, Aries. Where are we here? We must let go of the delusions of this earthly plane and embrace non-attachment and groundlessness. This feeling of scarcity and inadequacy is a cycle of negative energy we have been caught up in for quite a while. We are being called by spirit to go higher. The universe can see where we are weary and asking us to just stop. Stop chasing, stop fixating, and focus on attracting that which actually feeds our soul and nourishes our lives. And this is what all the queens are. You have double queens today, Aries. When we leave behind the grasping, desperate energies and instead focus on building up the energy of gratitude, compassion, and generosity, we become a powerful, abundant magnet. This magnificent magnet pulls from the universe all that we need to thrive and succeed in this lifetime and sends it directly towards us. No more desperation, no more wanting, no more FOMO. When we are confident that what we are asking for is in alignment with our spiritual path and the rhythm of the universe, we will always attract and receive not only what we need, but an abundance of joy and peace we never knew possible. So what a perfect card for you today, Aries, this bonus card. So perhaps these are worldly things that some of you might be attached to and you have to release because there's almost like this chase. And you're also looking for this path. So once you release yourself from some of those things in your life, you're going to open that path up and you're going to be able to walk right through. All right. So very, very interesting here for you. So let's now pull an angel number. Some of you have been seeing angel numbers in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation. And for others, you can use this as an affirmation. So we are getting number 99. I am courageous. So any of you seen number 99 anywhere in your life, know that you have courage. You are courageous, my friends. Also, Spirit guides might be asking some of you to embody the energy of the life path number 9. So look that up as well, Aries. I'm going to read the message on this card for you. It is time to get to work on the realization of your soul's mission in life. You have a higher purpose in this life that is yours and only yours to fulfill. Unleash your true power, Aries. So look at that. What a powerful message for you today. I hope this reading resonates for you. If it does, please comment below, hit that like button. And if you're brand new to my channel and you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing. Other than that, I wanted to wish you all a beautiful day and thank you so much for watching.